Hello, my boys. I'm very happy to show you a nice farming strategy. As you can know, I'm not a big blight lover, you know? But I want you to test the new keystone and see how good it is, you know? How fast the towers kill the monsters. As you know, in what league is this? Trail of the Ancestors. So they introduced new keystones, especially this one. Cassia's Pride. This will make the monsters take more damage from your towers, but you, on the other hand, will do less damage to the monsters. So I did some experiments with this keystone and I can say I love it. Okay? I'm not a big blight lover, but I love this keystone. And you also made profit. So I did this for the last 4 hours, and here is what I got. I will start with this, why not? As you can see, I got plenty of blighted maps. Also, these are Crimson Temple tier 16 blighted maps. They have a little more value because when you do them, you can get the apothecary or 7 years of bad luck. Yeah. Also, I got nice golden oils, and at the end, I will show you how to use oil extractors and we will get nice profit on top of what we got here. We will do a map showcase, but before that, let's talk about the Atlas setup. So, boys, first of all, if you are a noob, you know, because most of my viewers are noobs, I'm kidding. You're right here, Blight. And they will start to shine, you know, shine like bright like a diamond. And we look here, let me put the story short. You take most of them, some of them you don't need. For example, this one, you don't want the blight map crafting option. It sucks. You don't want your maps to have blight because we are using special scarabs, and I will explain you why. Here, what do we have? Maps have changed. Yeah, well, you don't want this shit. You want to save your points because I made an excellent setup, Atlas setup, that will guarantee you profit. So when you do profit with minimal investment. So everyone knows me that I like minimal investment with huge profit, okay? So you don't want to invest too much, but you want to get much out of your maps. This setup is excellent. It has a strong box setup that uses this keystone here, 7th gate, because we will put on the map device even more strong boxes, and it costs just 4C. Okay, strong bosses are overpowered, especially if you take the duplication nodes here, also for the divination cards. Also, if you kill the monsters, as you can see here, a strong boss in your max have 50% to spawn more monsters. Okay, so each strong boss has chance for the apothecary or 7 years of bad luck. If you get it from a strong box, it will get duplicated, which is powerful. Yeah, also you get nice loot from there, as you will see. This will always give profit. Also, we will take this node here, packed with energy that will give up to 105 more damage, 45% more woman's fee, so we will finish the map very fast, and some extra resistance, which are not bad. And of course, because you know me, we want to make profit with Nico. That's why we'll take this node here, mining byproducts, which will give us Azurite. And I will show you how to make profit with Nico out of nothing. This is not big profit, but you know, if we take pack with energy, usually you want to make up for the scarabs. Okay, I will explain you why that. Let's open some maps first because I like to show. I don't know, let's take a few maps. I want to check reflect. No, we don't have reflect. Boys, let's go to the fragment scarabs, and here is how I like to juice them. First of all, we will put a rusty sulfate scarab to trigger Nico. Yeah, you will need this. These are very cheap, don't worry. Because we are doing Crimson Temple and we have chance for the apothecary or 7 years of bad luck, make sure you use divination scarabs. I'll use the cheapest one because I'm a cheap man, you know. I don't want to pay much. If you want to pay much, it's good for you. Also, in the Atlas setup here, I took this node because I had extra points. Map device has 10% chance not to consume a scarabs. This will trigger from time to time and will save you scarabs on the long run. I like it. I like this. Okay, boys, let's go back to our scarabs. What I have here, I have a Rambush. You just use Rusted Rambush, it gives 3 additional strong boxes, one more for the from the skill tree, Atlas passive skill tree, and 4 more from the map device. It's nice. And we will have what else here. You will go for Gilded Blighted Scarabs, and I will explain you why. 50% chance for Blight's chest to contain an additional reward. 50% it's a lot. If you look here, this doesn't have it, so you need to go for Gilded. This is the only, it's not that expensive, you get 30 for one diviner, plus because we took that Atlas skill point, you will save some of them. This is not expensive, boys. So you buy these scarabs, you put a map, make sure you don't have shit modifiers and your build can handle it. Then you go here, let's remove these babies. Put the map here, you put your scarabs here. Put this ambush, which says area contains 4 additional strong boxes. So you get 4 additional strong boxes. For just 4 kills, sir. Boys, this is nice profit. Let's shut up already and open the map. Bam! Okay, in case you missed it, this is one of my newest builds. Okay, no, it's not new because I'm using it for more than 1 year. I made a new build guide on it on my channel, very useful. It's a magic finder that is extremely tanky. For those who don't know, look here, 95 chance to evade attacks, spell dodge, spell block, everything you want, everywhere. Okay, let's do this shit. So here you will start clearing the map. You look for Cassia. Also take these sulfide nodes because they will boost your movement speed, which is very useful. Look here, they give movement speed more damage and more defenses, which is nice. The map clearing will feel great. Yeah. Also, when you take the altars, the monsters become more cojones. They die harder. Yeah. You know what? Let's do a 2-gem because in my showcase for this build, I didn't do one. So let's do an expedition. I don't have the expedition notes, but who cares about that? Okay, I don't read them. I just look for the immunities, you know? Chose them, you know, we're good, huh? I don't read them, I think I put this shit. Okay, let's start. Come on, let's see the damage. Also, the chest open automatically because I have that mastery node, you know, when you use a spell, all the chests in the area open. It's useful. It's a lazy play, boys. So if you're lazy, go like this. Oh, yo, yo, yo. I didn't read the modifiers, okay? It's ruining my presentation. Oh, I was uninspired to take this shit. Uninspired. I don't know. They don't want to die. No problem here. We move on. Let's steal some stack decks. And run. I didn't read the modifier, so I don't care. I know this is a strong build, so don't worry. Not worry, this is very strong. Also, depends on the map modifiers. I haven't read them. Because this build can do all the modifiers. Okay, let's take this. I don't like to cut my videos, so I'll leave it as it is in the... I'll upload it like this. Okay. Because I know this is a great build, I don't need to edit my videos. Okay, now we look for Cassia. We look for Cassia in Apothecary, of course. If you get it, I'll start dancing. Come on. Bitch, stop running, bitch. Okay. As you can see, the damage is great, okay? So don't watch that failed expedition. Usually for expedition, you need to read the modifiers, you know? Sometimes you have shit modifiers. But I was cocky, I wanted to show you how great this build is, you know? Yeah. Where is Cassia? Ah, oh, okay, here, here. Okay, you go to her, you click here to start the Blight Encounter. I will talk about the towers. Also, I need to talk about my Ringanoids. Let's start first one, and after this map, I'll explain you what I took. I like to go for scout towers and arc towers. Depends on the immunities, so here I'm reading the immunities. I see I have no immunity to minion tower. That's why I'm making minion towers. But if I had minion towers immunity, I make arc towers. I bet you didn't understood anything, but I will explain you after this map. Okay, now it's easy mode. You keep making minion towers. Easy mode, because the towers do a lot of damage because of that new keystone. I love it. Lazy gameplay. Okay, and now you wait. You can make more towers if you want, but it's not that necessary because they do shit ton of damage. Put one here. Let's see, make one here. Come on. Good. Now we're good. And we stay here until the event stops. As you will see, we will get a lot of loot. Many times you can get Apothecary or 7 years of bad luck here, near the pump, from the Master's Guild. On top of the golden oils and the other good loot that we will get. I want to show you two things, so we need this to end. Let's check here. Okay, we're good. Look at the loot. Look how much loot we get. Look, high probability to get, you can get Apothecary right here. Also, when you see, you get some amulets anointed, you will pick them up. because we are going to use oil extractors, and I will show you how to do it the right way. Okay, let's see, we have here some oils. Okay, oil, more oil extractors, not bad. Usually I take the expensive oils. Many times you will get golden oils, don't be scared. We will make nice profit. Let's kill the map boss and I'll do some explanation. Why the fuck? Oh. Okay, I need to read the... Because of the map modifiers, boys will die hard. You know, some map modifiers are shit. You know, usually the boss dies very hard. But I don't read the map modifiers. I just put the map in the map device. And that's it. You will see in the next map the boss will die very fast. Okay, let's go back. Okay. What I wanted to show you about the towers. So, as you can see, that keystone is overpowered. The damage is great. But we have immunities. Some towers, some monsters are immune to minions. And we will use arc towers. Arc towers do shit ton of lightning damage. And they have like a chain lightning effect. So when they shoot, they will kill multiples at once, which is what we want. The other ring has this minion summon per scout towers, 25 increased damage. So you want this anoint. I think I remember the recipe for them. Let me think. Let's put this. So I think two ambers will give scout tower damage. And two verdant will give arc tower damage. Very easy to remember, boys. Ah, I taught you everything. So when you have these two enchants, you equip them on your left ring and on your right ring. Let's put our oils back and open a new map. We're gonna open a new map. And after that, I will show you how to use oil extractors to get even more profit. Okay. This is fun, boys. I really enjoy this. Okay, it's lazy play. You put ambush here and you open. Be sure to take the scarabs as I indicated. Also, if we look at our new Atlas setup, because you will use this setup because you know I'm great, you go here and you will notice that we also go for Aether altars, which is nice. We also have this one to get more progress towards the special invitation, more altars. It's nice. This setup, it's all you want. Let's do this map. Okay, we have Cassia there. Some people like to collect some altars. Some people, I suggest you to do it like this. Let's take also Nico here. So we're gonna clear a little of this map. Oh, I forgot again, I need to read the map modifiers, you know. If I have that, the monster have 40% elemental resistance. Again, the boss will die harder. Let's take this. Why not? Let's take this. Also, the altars can boost the life of the boss. Oh, I like lazy play, boys. I want to don't read a lot of text, you know? So we want more quantity, yeah. What's here? Oh, I read it. Okay, let's take this. This is also good. Okay, let's go towards Cassia. As you can see, the build is very tanky. I stood in the middle of the detonation and I'm still alive. This is a great build because it's also very tanky. Solid damage, tanky, and it's a magic finder. I have the build guide on my channel. Yeah. Also, it's a nice skill, you know. Rolling magma, brainless. You go in the middle of the monsters and you right click. One mouse button build. Okay, I like lazy builds. Also, it's tanky. I like tanky lazy builds. Let's start this shit. Okay, we put here. We check the immunities. So we can do here. We have lightning tower immunity. So we'll go with minion towers again. Let's see the layout. Okay, let's put the first tower here. We can start it. Okay, you do scout towers. Okay, we have here anoint. Scout towers 25% more damage plus the keystone. We do a lot of damage. As you can see, they die very fast. Look. One tower. Let's put one more here. One here. Okay, let's put one here. Very easy play. Now, because we don't have minion immunity and we took that big keystone, we just spam these towers and everything will die. I enjoy this a lot because it's very easy. Not to mention that you get experience, okay? At the moment I'm level 98, but if you're lower, you will get a lot of experience from Blight. Yeah. Easy mod, easy play. You can do more towers if you want, but it's overkill. Let's do one more here. Yeah, okay, now we wait. I like this a lot. Okay, so the new keystone is fun. This is what I can tell, it's fun. I need to stay here. Let's stay here, let's hide here. Oh! Let's see the monsters. The monsters die very fast. My screen got blurred, you know? There's a... You know, it saves my video card. So I don't lose a frame per second, you know? Let's see the loot. No apothecary, don't worry. Let's take some scrolls because I need them. Look at the amulets, I told you to take them. One amulet. Yeah, nothing interesting here. Let's open this. Nice, we take the oils. Let's see what we have here. No, I don't like it. Let's try here. Nothing great. I was hoping we get a divine orb or a golden oil, because you will get, in 5 maps, you will get at least one golden oil. I got shit ton of golden oils, but I don't want to make this video too long, because you got the idea. You'll also import my Atlas setup, yeah? And you will see, you make really nice profit. Also, you get 4 extra strong boxes for cheap. For what? For Chaos Orb? That's very cheap. That's very cheap. You'll get Diviner strong boxes, you'll get Operative strong boxes, also that Currency strong boxes. It's nice. It's a nice setup. Also, I'll say after we kill the boss. Let's kill the boss. Oh, it's possessed. Don't ruin my presentation, bitch. Okay, where it is? Where it is? Here. We'll die fast. It's a good build. Come on, die, bitch. Okay. What I want to say here, it's some of you will start yelling that you need to apply that sextant. You know, monster are enraged and you get 500 more quantity from your strongboxes. No. I'll explain like this. This is very cheap to run and those sextants are very expensive. Also, they have few charges. So you need to open here and apply that sextants multiple times. Yeah, which sucks. Yeah, which sucks. You will use that enraged strongbox sextant only if you use expensive juice. So, if you have an aura bot or friends to get more quantity, if you use only gilded or winged scaras, because that's expensive, it makes sense to use an expensive sextant with expensive juice. So, if I had here only gilded scaras and stuff like that, yeah, sure, you can go for expensive sextant. But because this is budget, we are not investing a lot of money, don't buy that shit, okay? Okay, let's put this back and now I will explain you how to do with the oil extractors. Yeah, I will explain you because many players don't know. Okay, let's sell this. I'm almost kept with the Orb of Fusings. Yeah. Okay, we go here in the oils. And you will notice here's oil extractor. You say, what the fuck is this shit? What? You put it in your ass, boys. No, you don't put it in your ass. You take it here. And we go... Where I put it? I think... here. No, here. Here. Balupatab. Balupatab, here I have it. So we are looking for golden oils. This you can right-click and you get golden oils. This I know for sure that Charisma has 2 golden oils, but some of them I don't know. I told you to take all the amulets that dropped, okay? So you have the amulets and you see they already have an enchant. And now you want to check the ones that have... one moment. So you will go here. I have here list of anointments. After you go on my channel and you watch all these great videos here, you know, maybe you want to see the builds that I'm using, you will go here. And here you have a list of anointments. I'll put this link in the description of the video. You take one amulet and you look at an anoint. You say here, Holy Fire, allocate Holy Fire. You go here on the website and you put Holy fire. Okay, we have silver, no golden oil, we destroy. Next one. Argent animosity. You go here and you write. Opalescent, no, we don't have golden oil, we destroy. Here, profane chemistry. You go here, you write. Silver oil, we don't have golden oil, we destroy. Or you can go for that silver oil, but I don't recommend. Let's say charisma, I know for sure it has two golden oils. If you see, if you write it here, if you write charisma. You see? Or polishing golden, good. This one, it's brutal blade. We go back. You got the idea. Oh, we have golden oil. So here we have 1 in 3 chance to get the golden oil. Good. We put it here. Next one, force of nature. No, let's try with this two. So here we have 2 in 1 to get a golden oil, and here we have 1 in 3 chance. So here we have 2 in 1 chance to go golden oil. Motherfucker. We didn't got it. Let's try here. We got it. And golden oil, it's how much? 78. So this is how you use your amulets. You check them and you will apply oil extractor. Let's put our oils back. Ah, okay. So now you know how to use this. So when you do in your maps and they drop these amulets will drop because of this node here. I think it's here. Look, black chest in your maps, 10% chance to contain an oil extractor. That's why we got these amulets anointed. You will pick them up and we'll check which ones have golden oils. Then you will use oils, oil extractors to get the golden oils. Nice profit, boys. You will also get this. There are Blighted Crimson Temple maps. Sell them on TFT Discord. I did some testing and these are not that profitable as they seem. So you're better off running this setup in your maps. Yeah? And you will get Divine Orbs, Golden Orbs, also you can get Apothecary or 7 Years of Bad Luck. Pretty nice. Not to mention you open all those strong boxes and you have progression towards Eater of Worlds. So you get those special invitations. Yeah? Which sell very good. I want to check the price today for it. So we go here. Here. Yeah. 1.1 divine orb, or if you sell more than 10 in bulk, you can get 1.2 divine orbs. Yeah, let's do one more map, why not? This is the last map, so you get the idea. I really enjoy this new Keystone, and I will... whole day, today I will play only this. Each map that you will run with this setup will make you profit. Okay, so don't have to worry. Ah, I forgot, I'll show you how to make money with Nico. Yeah, after this map. So not only we get these buffs at the top, you can also make money. Okay, let's start this. First we check the immunities. Let's do the Arc Towers. Yeah, boy. So we go here, we start with Arc Towers. This is overpowered. So you put the Anoint, also you have the Keystone. This one, Arc Tower. Has great clear. Let's start the event. If you have both immunities, Master and Arc, you will do both towers. Both Arc and Masters. So we just spam this. Very easy. Oh, need to put one here. Okay, now we are good. 100% good. Because these towers are overpowered. I love it. I love it. This gameplay, I love it. It's very lazy, you know. After you make the towers, you stay here. Let's look a boss how fast dies. Already died. You just stay here and you wait for the loot. After the loot appears, you get your apothecary and your golden oils and you finish the map. Okay, let's see. Give me apothecary. You see? Look how much loot. Okay. I took some scroll of portals, fuck this shit. Okay, let's see what we got here. I want something big, you know? Usually when I close the video, I start getting mirrors, apothecaries, you know? But when I make the video, I don't get them, boys. I don't get them. Let's look here. Jack in the box. Fuck this shit. Let's kill the boss. And I'll show you how to make money with your Nico. Okay, I hope that this bitch will die fast. Okay. Look, when you have easy modifiers, so you don't have that elemental resistance on boss, it will die very fast. Okay, so this is a great build. I didn't use this, which will give a strong damage boost. Okay, and now I'll show you how to make money with Nico. As I told you in this guide, we'll take these nodes. Packed with energy will give you more movement speed, which we like. Also, more than 100% increased damage out of thin air. And you also get this. So, 10% chance to get Azurite also. And I'm pretty sure we got some. You go here into mine encampment. Okay, once you're here, you're gonna talk with Nico and purchase items. Here is your Azurite. This I got solely from maps. So by now, the only thing I did, I went here and I upgraded this sulfate capacity because I don't know, I feel like you need to upgrade like 2 times to get more. You know, I'm not a Delph player, so correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, so we go here and you will buy this. Primitive Chaotic Resonator. Because you are a primitive player, you will buy Primitive Chaotic Resonator, which are pretty cheap. Also, this sells in bulk free Chaosor, very easy. And you're gonna buy them. Okay, so here we have 4, we made 10 Chaos Orb. 10 Chaos Orb, let's buy more. 20 Chaos Orb. 40 Chaos Orb. You got the idea, you buy this and you sell them in bulk. Okay, so for the Scarabs, Sulfate Scarabs, Rusty Sulfate Scarabs that we bought with, you will make your money back and make profit. So, not only that you will have this buff here, you'll also get your money back for the Sulfate Scarabs using this node. So, my advice you, what? I allocated 3 points. Okay, this was one of my secrets, I will share them now. Because many players just take this point and totally ignore this. Buy from Nico, you'll buy this Primitive Chaotic Resonators and you will sell them in bulk. Usually it's 80 Resonators, 1 Divine Orb. Boys, I hope this was useful to you. You will apply this setup and you will do Blight because you like oils, you know? You like to play with oils, so you'll do Blight. Have a great day and good luck.